Hello lovely people and welcome to another video in the DIS-TANZEN series where we are trying to find the best ways for us to bring our live classes online. Today I'm talking to my good friend Lucy, who is a dancer, theater maker and performer, and we've been working together to provide her with a light traveler's budget pack setup for her online sessions. Welcome Lucy. Tell us a little bit about how you want to use your gear, and then we go into what gear did we decide to get eventually.
Hi, Ali. Thank you so much for having me. So we've been working together, and we have decided to go with the version of your suggestions called the Hack, because it's the lightest and least material, and for me as a maybe not super techie person, a very accessible option. To improve the quality of synchronicity and sound quality and level of comfort as I'm teaching classes online. So what we've got are some really exciting new technology from Rode. We've got these microphones. I'll kind of hold it up close. There's a little bit of, you can see my ring light in there. But these little microphones, it's even still got the tag. Oh, this is exciting.
Oh, that's such a great moment.
Isn't it? So these microphones are called the Wireless Go-To, and I think you talked about those in your last video. And so I've got that on today, and there's two of them, which is what makes it the most interesting. And for the Hack, we're going to have one on me as a dance teacher and one on my tiny little travel-size Bluetooth speaker. And this little Bluetooth speaker, I think, was like $15 on Amazon, so it's nothing super fancy, but it is very light, very travelable, and I just kind of, it's a little bit like more direct to come from the front of it, so I tilt it on its side and then have the speaker right, the microphone right in front of it. And that's kind of off to the side where there's no block of my Bluetooth signal coming from my computer to this, because if I get in front of it, it's just a tiny little $15 speaker, it's already blocking the sound. So I've got this kind of off to the side, and we'll maybe show a little setup time lapse in a minute of how we've got this set up, this little travel size, how to teach a dance class in a bag. We've got these microphones. I've got this amazing light. We talked a lot about light when you and I were chatting, and I know you mentioned it in your video. So this is just a very, like, it's kind of heavy. It's heavier than my phone is. I've got an Android. But it's a similar size and, you know, very compact, but it delivers an insane amount of light. Like, I blinded myself.
Uncomfortable amount of light is exactly what I was saying, yeah.
Yeah. So it has tons of amazing options. You can make, like, party lights. And for me as a theater maker, it's useful. There's other settings of, like, lightning and blah blah blah, but that's not relevant for us for dance classes. But you can kind of choose a colored light to have, like you have in the background right now, or just a really nice warm light. And it comes along with this little tripod. And then the cool thing about this is that it's got this, I don't even know what the technical term is, but you know, you can hinge, load it onto
a hinge or something like that.
Yeah, I don't know. People are they can write it into the comments.
Exactly.
you can put it on your camera if you have a nicer, you know, nicer camera, an icon or something. You can screw that on, and there's different options. So this is really flexible and very compact, easy to travel with.
That piece, how much was that? How much did that cost?
That was like, I think $70.
Right, so it's relatively affordable as well for what it brings, actually.
For what it offers, the strength of the light is very impressive. I'm like already blinded. and then I've got a tiny little travel size ring light, clip on to a phone or to my computer. And then I've got an Ethernet cable. It's about 25 feet long. And I've got that connected over to the router in the corner. Right here, all the cables in this empty room.
Good. thing is so important that we are so used to be wireless that we forget that we even have that option. But it's crucial for high quality upload and download speed.
Yeah, we did the speed check and it made a really big difference. I mean, I guess we're close with Wi-Fi, close enough to the router that's like maybe okay, but when we've talked from another room in this house, you notice.
Yeah, not the same quality at all.
Yeah, for sure.
And that also makes a difference in sound and video sort of that goes through the internet, that the poorer quality internet you have, the lower the chance to get your sound and video synchronized, actually. So,
Yeah, and you and I have done a lot of tests of the sound, like how is it if we're sharing sound through the computer? How is it if we're sharing sound with this secondary Rode mic picking up the sound from my computer into this mic? And how is it doing the Bluetooth? And our just, you know, tests that we did through Zoom were basically confirming what you guys talked about in your last video with your sound technician of the hack being doing the Bluetooth. It's also what I noticed as a teacher when I was testing things out and I've got the sound coming through my phone connected to that Bluetooth speaker, I can adjust volume up and down very comfortably, and the level of volume that's comfortable for me in my space as I'm teaching is also what's comfortable for the person, for the participant dancer on the other side. So that's nice for me to know, okay, if it's loud for me, it's probably loud for them. And if I want to be loud to tell them something while I'm teaching, I can lower the volume and it'll still balance out well. So that's a very comfortable option.
That's great information, because that's not at all obvious. That's not obvious. Often we end up having to have very poor sound experience for ourselves in order for it to be comfortable for the participants, so to say, or when it's comfortable for us, it's not good for the participants. And having that being on the same level is actually very, very helpful in order to be in control of the atmosphere we're creating. Yeah,
absolutely. It's something you and I talked about a lot, is like, what is the difference between what helps us deliver good quality and what's comfortable for us to teach with. And you kind of have to balance that out, you know, a comfortable, uncomfortable amount of light. So maybe my comfort as a teacher is there, not above the comfort of the viewing experience and being able to see me moving in space. But with sound, it's just so nice with this new setup to be able to know, okay, when I change something, it's about the same as what they're hearing on the other side. Obviously, with the participant being able to control how loud their computer or their device is giving that sound back, but just at least to know, okay, it's somewhat similar. That feels a little bit more like being in the real space together. It's way more comfortable than just having to ask my participants the whole time, can you hear me? Can you hear the music? Do you need me to adjust? Having to type it in the chat, you know, that kind of stuff we've been dealing with for a year now with Zoom. But yeah, so this new setup is really, really nice. Would you like to give it a try? Should I show you?
Yes, I would love to see that with the music and the sound and getting synchronicity.
Yeah, so I've got my Rode mics. We found that it doesn't make a huge difference whether the Rode is splitting the sound. These wireless Go's allow you the option of doing mono or stereo sound, and mostly through Zoom, it kind of just ends up putting it all together anyway. But it is nice with this option of having them split. I can see how the, so it's registering the different volume levels. It's really hard to show you that through this camera, but anyway,
no,
you know what I'm talking about. So I can see the volume levels going when I've got it on split on this little receiver. So that's just nice for me to be able to monitor what's coming in on both microphones. All right, so I'll step away from you and turn on a little bit of music, and we'll see how that synchronicity is working and how I can move through space. Here we go. Yeah. I probably wouldn't count to that level. But if I wanted to chat with participants, with my dancers, and say, hey, how did that work for you? Maybe we could try this. Remember, yeah, on count five, we're gonna do something like this, or really feel the rhythm, get down into it. I can turn the music down, but not have to turn it completely off. Or conveniently with my phone, I've got it right here in my hand. So my phone's a little bit big. Some people have really small phones. You could even tuck it into a pocket and it's right there as you're talking. As you're teaching, you can control everything right from your hand. And then we can turn that back on and practice a little bit together again.
Great, great. I don't know. I don't know yet how this will transfer over into the recording, but from my side, it was a little bit distorted once you went to the highest volume. So I would maybe prevent from the top level volume, but comfortable. Of course, for everybody at home to know as well. Like, if you share internally, you will get better quality sound than what we have here. But it's then you have to go through a lot more work in order to synchronize. Now, in your case, Lucy, I would probably do a little bit more work in figuring out what's the right volume for the microphone versus the music. I think we can do some micro adjustments with that, because I think at points I wanted to have your voice a little bit louder. Mm-hmm. But we've tried this before. We know it works. To have that better quality, I think it's just a matter of the boosting the gain a little bit more, or finding the better distance between the speaker and the microphone music, so that it balances better with your voice. So this is something for people at home as well. You just need to tinker a little bit from that, but it's really nothing more than, like, here's your speaker, here's your microphone. You just sort of see, like, what distance is enough for you. These microphones expects you to be relatively close, so you want to still stay within the close spectrum. The moment you go a little bit too far away, it becomes like an empty room sound again. But it's really cool. It was perfectly synchronized. The fact that you can play with the volume on your phone, that's something that is possible to set up as well in through other softwares for your computer, for those who really want to have that feature for other setups. But I'll let you do the research on your own at home when it comes to that one.
So one thing that I would add to that too is that another level of comfort for me is having my participants, my dancers, on the computer speaker. So they're able to speak to me and I can keep my computer volume up as high as possible. So if somebody does have a question, I can hear them and I don't have to have them competing with the volume of the music. If I hear somebody saying something or see a wave, I can immediately respond to that, turning down the music on the Bluetooth speaker, and you're right there at the right volume level for me to hear.
And it doesn't create a loopback. This was one thing I was unsure about, where the speaker, the sound from your computer speakers would be picked up by your microphone and get you launched in a loop, so to say. But it doesn't do it, and I think it's because how Rode is connected through a USB-C cable, and Zoom basically recognizes that and separates those channels. That's what I'm assuming is happening. So that's really great that we can have that experience to have music loud enough for you to comfortably hear. It's loud enough for the participants, and you can hear the participants through other pair of speakers, and these sounds are not competing inside of your microphone. That's fantastic. I was unsure a little bit about that, but now we know that works. That's great.
Yeah, it's really nice. So the cool thing too, Ali, is that if you're noticing, okay, I'm really trying to talk a lot as I'm working with music, you have the option of just manually choosing how close is my microphone to my Bluetooth speaker. If we've got it pretty close, you'll want to do a little sound check and make sure that the quality is nice enough. But you're going to have really loud music and maybe you're not working so much with your voice while you're using music, and you're just kind of making sure that your body is synchronized with what's coming in. But if you need a little bit more talking room over the music that you're sharing, you can figure out what angle you want your speaker at and how far away you want the Rode mic. So we'll give that a little test. The one just before was super close and it was a little bit hard to hear my voice. And we'll try it out now a little bit further away and a little bit less direct. So I'll let you tell me how that sounds in comparison. Nice.
Sound is good. Very synchronized.
With the music quite loud, so if I want to turn that down some, I can talk to you still and use a little bit more projection in my voice to make sure that I'm really reaching you, but the music is nice and controllable in my hand. There we go.
Great. Yeah, that was fantastic.
Yeah,
much better quality. Yeah, nice. That's fantastic. Yeah.
Yeah, and it's nice to just have that option, you know. Like, if you're not super techie, it's just a matter of figuring out what's the right distance, rather than a lot of different controls you have to manage on your computer. So that works well for me.
Let's actually do a before shot afterwards as well, so that we just get to see how it is when we run it just through shared sound. So Zoom's function of sharing the computer sound. And using the regular computer speaker, basically no additional gear, just a raw basic you and your laptop sort of thing. So we get a comparison of what is the pros and cons that we're experiencing.
Mm-hmm. So to do that, for the first one, I'm going to mute the second mic, which you can still hear me, right? I'm not muted.
Yeah, no.
Yeah, great. So I've muted the mic that was coming through my Bluetooth speaker so we don't have double pickup. And then I'm just going to share that same song with you through my computer, and we're going to see how my voice layers on top of that internal computer shared sound. Got my volume all the way up. Turn that down just a little bit. 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 5, 6,
So the crazy part is like this time it was pretty well synchronized again. We ran this just before shooting, and one time it was completely off, the other time it was pretty well synchronized again. And so one of the challenges with this method is it fluctuates a lot. It even fluctuated from the beginning of your recording until towards the end. So in the beginning was more synchronized a little bit, the last time you were counting it was a little bit more off. Mm-hmm. Compared to the before. So there's a lot of unpredictability into this method, and that's an experience I've had as well. And it really depends also on how many participants you have, because the more participants you have, the more bandwidth is required, and then it gets even more unpredictable. And just in general, if you have a good internet day or bad internet day, it will affect that as well. So that's one of the major drawbacks. You don't know actually what your users are getting.
Yeah.
The other one, maybe you explained as well, you were saying that you couldn't hear it well.
Yeah, so when I have the sound coming from my computer to make it a comfortable level for me to know that my voice is coming through, I've got to turn it down quite low, and then it's hard for me to really be, it's like feel the music and to make sure that I'm also counting the right time. And so I think the Bluetooth option is a lot more comfortable because I can control a little bit more how loud that sound is going to be and still feel like I can hear it to perform and or to dance or to teach with. I do know, I mean, the response has been that internally shared sound is the best quality. And I think you could probably hear that at least the music quality is a little bit better than with the Bluetooth speaker. So if I were going to do a round where we say, hey, let's improvise together, or hey, let's practice that choreography together, and I'm not doing a lot of vocal cueing, then I would definitely try to share the sound through the computer. If we're going to listen to 2 minutes of a song and I'm not going to speak, we're just going to dance, or I'm going to try and watch participants, I would share through my computer to give them the best sound quality.
Right, right. Let's do one last one. And that is when you also turn off the Rode microphone that you have on you. So it's completely from just your laptop.
Back to the roots.
Back to the roots.
So we should, can you hear me? I've got my...
What a difference.
Yeah?
It's a big difference, yeah.
In quality of sound or?
Yeah. Yeah, the Rode... this one sounds more empty room, or like the twang is a little bit more, so it's louder, but it's distorted a little bit.
So if you're just teaching class with a laptop, it's doable. In those cases, the times that I've taught classes with just my laptop, I've always used shared computer sound. But there is the option, if you have just a Bluetooth speaker, of putting that speaker at a sort of angle away from your internal mic. So I've got my microphones kind of down here on the laptop, and then have the, you know, just at an angle away from. But we'll do the test now with just the laptop, no Bluetooth speaker, and sharing sound internally. So I'm talking to you. This is what it sounds like when I move away from the computer, and I'm describing, we're gonna go 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If I wanna talk a little bit louder and describe how we're moving, I might try and project more to make sure that you can hear my voice from that microphone far away, but in this sort of empty space, I can already tell that the sound quality of my voice just isn't as nice. It's probably not coming through in a comfortable way. I'm sure you can hear me, but it's not as pleasant, I would imagine.
Yeah.
And then when I share sound with you, we'll listen to Functionalizing again from the fabulous Fats Waller.
So I could not hear anything from what you were saying. So the moment you stepped away, I don't know if Zoom took it out or if it was just swallowed by the music. I think Zoom took it out because it was this typical like algorithm removing sound sort of quality to it. And you were off. I mean, Lucy, friends don't let friends dance on... Oddbeat.
So embarrassing.
So embarrassing indeed. No, but this is what I'm talking about. Like it's random. Just by switching off the other microphone, I don't know if that had to do anything with it, but this time around you were off. in comparison to the music. So that's the risk we're having when we are not in control of the whole process and transferring the sound and the video together properly.
Yeah. So we also have talked about in your previous videos about using original sound. Right. So now I've got original sound on, and that maybe we can do a second test just to see if that would allow a little bit more of my voice to be picked up. So I'll turn on functionalizing again, and I'm going to turn it. The problem I'm having, and it's different with each song, you know, some songs you have, some MP3s are just a little bit louder or the quality is a little bit more. This one's somewhat quieter. So when I'm moving away, it's really quite hard to hear. And then when I count over it to try and project into this microphone on my laptop that's far away from me, I'm having to really like cover up all the sound that's coming in. So it's very challenging.
Abort, abort. Yeah, no, it was the same thing. I could not hear you and it was off.
Yeah.
Comes to the first point. So that it's just, it's very random, the experience when you don't have a little bit extra gear. But what I'm really happy about is with such a small addition of extra gear, you could get a very, very much improved experience for yourself as a teacher, because you can fill the room with a lot more music and have more control. And the experience for the participants is still very good and synchronized, which makes it better than just high quality sound, but not synchronized, because it's very distracting to watch and join.
Yeah. So thank you, Ali, for not letting me tap on the
mic. It was my pleasure. I'm happy to be the count police anytime. Now, it's been a pleasure to going through this with you, and with extra challenge of making sure everything is portable and travel ready. So enjoy your sessions and have a continuous good teaching.
Thank you so much for your help, Ali. These have been great. I love all the videos that you've been producing so far. I found it extremely helpful. And having this little travel pack ready to go makes me feel like kind of wherever I am in the world at that time, I can still reach out to my dance students and be able to offer something and share and connect. I think that's what we're really focusing on most with this DIS-TANZEN project, like bringing people closer. So I feel like this equipment is a huge leap forward without completely, you know, burning through limited budget. So I appreciate it so much. Thanks for having me on to chat with you.
Yeah. Thank you.